Hey, what's up, producers? Welcome back to another Bass to Sub Bass tutorial. And today we're talking EQ, harmonic distortion, and I'm going to show you how you can get a clean fat sub in a perfectly balanced mix using Izotope's Neutron 4 equalizer and Ozone 10 exciter in Ableton Live. In the previous tutorial, you created a powerful sub with the sub kick maker. If you haven't seen what this audio effect can do for your bass line, you should definitely check it out after this video. So, with the sub kick maker effect, this is what you have now. The sub is powerful, alright, but it's muddy and it's masking my kick a little. But with EQ, harmonic distortion, and sidechain compression, that's what you'll get. In this video, I'm going to show you how to EQ the sub and add harmonic distortion. If you haven't subscribed yet, do it now. In the next tutorial, you will learn how to properly apply sidechain compression so your kick can cut through your sub or your bass line. Let's move on to step one, how to EQ a sub. First, insert your favorite EQ to your bass channel in Machine. Because Ableton Live is pretty laggy with third-party plugins, I use them in Machine whenever I can. Here, I'm using Neutron 4 equalizer. Sidechain to the kick now, you will understand why in a few seconds. And we will need four filters to clean up this sub. One, let's get rid of unwanted low frequencies. For a sub like this, add a high pass filter at around 40 Hz, there is nothing interesting below that. You can experiment with different slopes, but for now, 12 dB is fine. Two, add a low pass at around 440 Hz. You will not need anything above that. Three, let's remove muddiness so we can get a cleaner sub. Swipe between 200 and 300 Hz. You will quickly hear what frequency to cut. Here, I'm cutting 7 dB at 225 Hz and I just need to widen the Q a little. 4. Let's give the kick a little more space. You can see the kick and the sub share the same frequency range. In this example, I'm boosting my kick 4 dB at 55 Hz, so I'm cutting my sub 4 dB at 55 Hz, but only when the kick hits. And that's why you need to sidechain the EQ to the kick. To avoid masking, make this filter dynamic so this frequency ducks out when the kick hits. Now, let's A/B. And that's how you get a clean sub. Now it's time to add warmth with harmonic distortion. Insert Ozone exciter on your bass channel or bass bus in Ableton Live and select warm low end. Leave it to stereo and for the 80-300 Hz band, set the exciter mode to triad, amount at around 8.5 and mix at 100%. Let's say B again. And there, you're done. Clean, fat, but we want it to duck out of the way when the kick hits, and you will learn how to do that in the next video with sidechain compression using the Fat Filter Pro C2 plugin. Don't forget to subscribe and happy producing!